S-Chan presents educational video lectures as per the AICTE curriculum. Difficult concepts made easy. Study anywhere, anytime.
In part one, we discussed the kinds of sentences, we discussed about phrases and clauses. In part two, we are going to discuss more about the punctuation marks, and we are going to discuss the importance of punctuation mark in details along with examples. Welcome to S-Chand Academy. I'm Dr. Vidushi Bhardwaj. To know more about the subject, word formation and vocabulary building, you may refer to this book by CAS Publications. The link has been given below. Moving ahead with the next punctuation mark, which is a semicolon. It is the most commonly used mark to mark a break that is stronger than a comma, but it is not as final as a full stop. So wherever we put a break, which is a slight bigger break, which is used between two main clauses that balance each other and are too closely linked to be made into a separate sentence. For example, the film was a critical success, semicolon, its lead actors were particularly praised. We see a break, but it's a slightly bigger, longer break, we would say, than a comma. Then there is a colon. There are three main uses of colon between two main clauses in cases where the second clause explains or follows from the first. So we have a motto, live life to the full. To introduce a list, we put a colon. So whenever we are making a list, we are trying to list down the items we have to bring, or we are trying to introduce certain items, we put a colon. So the cost of the room included the following: breakfast, dinner, and Wi-Fi, a colon before this will tell you that this is the list we are talking about. Before a quotation and sometimes before direct speech also we use a colon. For example, the headline read a colon, and then we can put quote or a direct speech, local woman saves geese. So this has to be a colon and then a quotation. Then comes the apostrophe. There are two main cases where apostrophes are used. Using an apostrophe to show possessive case. So for example, Malcolm's cat was extremely friendly. When you are trying to show the possessive case of a noun, a boy's pen, a girl's scarf, we use an apostrophe. We took a day trip to the Gibson's house. Using apostrophe is also used, you know, to show some kind of an omission, how to omit. So for example, I'm afraid the pie is not suitable for vegetarians. We did not think about the consequences of our actions. So I'm afraid the pie is not as isn't. And this is how, you know, we have to understand that when do we use omission and when do we use possession case to use apostrophe. Then comes a hyphen. Hyphen is the most misused punctuation mark, I would say. They are used to link words and parts of words. There are three main cases where you should use them. In compound words, for example, my mother-in-law is visiting soon. So this compound word mother-in-law, we have hyphen in between. We cannot join the word mother-in-law without the hyphen. To join prefixes to other words, the novel is clearly intended to be a post-war work. And to show word breaks, he collects 18th and 19th century vases. So this again is clearly indicated through hyphen. Now there is this difference between a hyphen and a dash, and people use it, you know, mixingly, thinking that this is one and the same thing, but it is not the same. Dash, there are two main occasions on which a dash can be used, usually in informal writing. So we use a dash where we can use a colon and vice versa, but it should not be used the other way around. So to mark off information that is not essential to an understanding of the rest of the sentence, to show other kinds of break in a sentence where a comma, semicolon or colon would be traditionally used. For example, Tommy can't wait for Christmas, a dash. He is very excited. So if you see, it's a longer indication as compared to a hyphen. A hyphen is used in compound words, while a dash is not used in compound words. So there is a confusion amongst the students most of the times as to where to put a hyphen and where to put a dash. And a dash, sometimes people use dash even in place of a colon where they are trying to introduce a list, but that should not be used. So what is a bracket now? There are two main types of brackets. We find we have round brackets, and they are used to separate off information that is not essential to the meaning of the rest of the sentence. For example, if there is some additional information you are trying to give to the readers about somebody or something, you can put that additional information in the form of a bracket. So he asked Sara, who was Sara? His great aunt. So we cannot put it in the rest of the sentence as a part of a sentence. So we are putting it in a bracket. For a loan, square, while square brackets are mainly used to enclose words added by someone other than the original writer or speaker, typically in order to clarify the situation. For example, the witness said Gary, who was Thompson, and was not actually usually late for work. So who was Gary? Gary Thompson. So in that case, it is put in the square bracket. So there is a slight difference in the usage, but of course, most of the time we use round brackets in the sentences so as to know, some additional information about the sentence. Now we have inverted commas. Inverted commas are mainly used to mark the beginning and end of a direct speech. There wasn't, he said, any need for you to say that. To mark off a word or phrase that is being discussed, that is being directly quoted for someone else, and so on. We always use inverted comma for the direct speech where we are trying to, you know, give quotations verbatim from the text, either from a poem or a text, a novel or a story. We put that in the inverted commas because that shows that it's been taken directly from the text. Then we have the exclamation mark. It is a mark of explanation which shows some kind of a feeling or a surprise or some kind of exclamatory mark. So the main uses of exclamation is to end sentence which is expressive in nature. For example, oh, that hurts. May God bless you, an exclamatory mark there. Then they thought I was dressed as a smuggler, and then an exclamatory mark. So any sentence which shows some sudden feelings or emotions will end with an exclamatory mark. Usually they are used commonly used in informal writing, but they can be used in formal writing as well. But people do not understand that it is not something which can be used in place of a full stop. It shows sudden surprise or fear or action or emotion. Then we have a question mark, as the name suggests, which is used to indicate the end of a question. So if we are asking a question, we put a question mark, not a full stop or an exclamatory mark. So what time are you going to the fair? A question mark. It can also be used in brackets to show that the writer is unconvinced by a statement, but we usually don't use this anymore, and we use a question mark straight away to show the question. Then we have bullet points, which are used to draw attention to important information within a document so that a reader can identify the key issues and facts quickly. This actually creates coherence in your writing when you are, using it as a part of your writing to show your good writing skills. So for example, when I make some kind of explanation after my sentence and I put that in bullet points, bullet 1, 2, 3, 4, that shows that my writing is coherent, clear, precise, and it's easily understandable by the readers. So after we complete with the punctuation mark and especially the bullet points, we need to understand the organizing principles of paragraphs in documents. Once we have discussed the sentence construction, sentence structure, punctuation marks, phrases, clauses, that automatically teaches us how we can write, effectively, and how we can organize paragraphs well when we are writing an essay or anything else. So any document for that matter can be divided into three parts clearly. which includes an introduction which will introduce the topic or the content. Then we have the body or the content of the paragraph, which actually explains more about the topic, and the facts and figures and all these details will be given in the body of the content, which will include all that important analysis and relevant information which will prove your point. And then we have a conclusion. A conclusion is a very important part of any document, any paragraph or document or anything which is a part of your writing. A conclusion has to be a natural outcome of the beginning and the middle part of the paragraph. Each part of the paragraph plays an important role in communicating the meaning you intend to convey. But yes, as a basic principle, if you are into writing, and of course, if you are into writing a paragraph or an essay or any part of, you know, important topic given to you as students, you have to understand, first of all, the technicalities of the language, which is grammar, sentence construction. You should be accurate, and then you can devise your paragraph into three parts, which will include the introduction, the content, and the conclusion. Help you achieve very good results in terms of achieving clarity of writing and speaking automatically. So, students, this is the end of the second part. And we discussed about very important elements in the language, which is English. We talked about the sentence construction. We talked about the sentence structure, phrases, clauses. We discussed the punctuation marks along with the examples. How should they be, you know, tackled and written carefully? We talked about the paragraph coherence, achieving coherence in paragraph writing, where introduction, content, and conclusion is important. And if you take care of all these things, I'm sure you're going to achieve good mastery over the language in terms of writing and speaking both. To know more about the subject, word formation and vocabulary building, you may refer to this book by Kaz Publications. The link has been given below. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon and keep looking for our future updates.
All rights reserved. This video has been prepared for educational purposes only. No part of it may be reproduced or copied without the permission of the copyright holder.